What's going on, guys? So today's video, we're going to be diving into the luxurious brand of Jaguar. Yes, the car brand Jaguar itself. Man, do they do some quality cars, but their fragrances are something else. Before I name what fragrance we're talking about today, please forgive that douchey-ass thumbnail. Trying to grab your attention. And this one has been requested for quite some time, but today we're going to be talking about Jaguar Classic or Jaguar Classic Blue. This fragrance has really been requested a lot by you guys. Whenever I do these top Jaguar videos with my wife or with Rush, or whenever I just talk about a Jaguar fragrance, someone always asks in the comment section, can I please do this review? So here you are. I ended up going through 1.5 samples. I still have another one left. This one is pretty much empty, so I am not buying it, even though it's very, very economical. This fragrance came out in 2002, so it's been around for a very long time, and the classification is an aromatic fougère. The note breakdown for this one here. So please forgive the note breakdown. I'm just gonna read it off from the official sample. Top notes are lavender, mandarin, basil, anise or star anise, bergamot, juniper, and orange with the heart bean, lotus flower, ginger, and orange flower, and the base is white musk, sandalwood, and benzoin. So what do I get out of this official sample here that I ended up getting from FragranceNet? In the opening, I get that citrus, I also get the juniper berries, but it's very much overshadowed by that star anise. The star anise is very spicy, it adds a lot of warmth to the scent, and it does remind me of other fragrances that I have smelled before. I can't put my finger on it, but I have smelled something like this before. When I think of star anise, however, I'm thinking of Boyce 1920 Sushi Imperial, which is done way better than this, and it costs a hell of a lot more as well. So if you're wearing Boyce 1920, chances are you're probably driving a Jaguar because that's very expensive. And then during the dry down, there is like, it does tone down a little bit. That first hour to 90 minutes, oh my, it's quite heavy and quite annoying, unfortunately. And then it does tone down where I get a little bit of that lavender, more so in the mid, not exactly in the opening. And there is a little bit of that ginger. Then towards the base, I still get some lavender with a slight star anise or spicy chord, but the musk does come into play and I don't get the other notes. This fragrance in the opening, as I said, is quite boisterous, quite loud, quite annoying, and it can be very overpowering, especially if you over apply with this one here. And then maybe like 1.5 to 2 hours, it does tone down to something quite nice. This fragrance is very spicy, it's citrusy, it has that fresh component, and I find it's more of a youthful type of scent. Now, if you're an older guy like myself, I'm 43, so I'm not old, I'm not young neither. If you're a guy my age and you like to wear this, hey, by all means, wear what you want. But I find that this really does have more of a younger man's disposition, has that younger man's feel. So when to wear this one? This will shine very well in the springtime. I think that in the fall because of that opening, and I would say on a summer evening out, not when it's daytime, summertime, this will be way too much for that hot, humid weather. This is casual, I would say something fun, a night out. This is not a club scent. And when I'm thinking of something fun, I think that you can wear it like, you know, let's say like a casual dinner out with your friends, then to a movie afterwards or bowling, or you could just wear it on a casual date. This is not a formal, classy type of scent. I do find it has some flirtatiousness to it, some fun aspects, and maybe with that star anise, it has a little bit of that sexiness as well. Longevity off this sample was great. I got 7 to 9 hours in projection. That first hour, no way. Really, really heavy, but it does tone down after like 1.5 to 2 hours to something that's actually quite nice. Prices for these are $25 or less. I've seen these as low as $12 USD, which is a phenomenal price tag. Wife's thoughts on this scent. Wife does like it. not in the opening, but during the dry down, when it does tone down quite a bit. She gets a lot of the spices, the citruses, some lavender, and that ginger. And she did say that it's more of a fun type of scent. So my final thoughts of Jaguar Classic Blue, Jaguar Classic, whatever it is. I do like this scent, yet it's not one that I'm gonna go out and get. I'm all about saving money and being economical, and yes, this is quite cheap, but it's not one that I want in my collection. I have plenty of Jaguar fragrances. Yes, that this is a good scent, but it's not one that I want in my collection. This is definitely more so suited for a younger man to my nose, and that is just my opinion. It's a good casual type of scent that lasts a long time. The opening is a banger. I think that this will certainly garner you compliments if you are looking for compliments and who just wants to save a lot of money. You don't have to spend a lot of money in order to smell good, and this is definitely the exception. This is definitely a banger, and for what you're paying, a great scent for a younger man. My rating out of 5, because it's not really along my taste, this is still going to get a solid rating of a 3.5 out of 5. It's just not one that I really am going to reach or really am going to wear ever again. If I wear it, I'm just going to pair it off against like another fragrance and get maybe my wife's take or somebody else's take as well. So guys, that is my take of Jaguar Classic Blue, or just Jaguar Classic. So hopefully you guys like this video. Guys, that's it. Thank you for your time. Take care, and I will see you later. Thanks for watching, everybody.